Let's dive into today's topic, all about how to create predictable income monthly in your business in a noisy market. That's what our topic is about today. I came with my notes ready. I planned this out on Sunday, I think. I've got 5 things that I want to teach you today. So come on in, tell me, welcome. We're super excited to have you here. I'm so glad you found this place, this location, this space in like an infinite online world of so many people teaching you so many things. Welcome. My name is Megan Hewer. And if you don't know me, I work with service-based women entrepreneurs and I help them grow and scale their businesses to 6 or multiple 6 figures. We can do that in 12 months or less, mind you, if you show up and implement and do the work. And I love bringing simplicity, systems, structure, and high-level strategy into your world, because as you and I both know, the internet world, the online marketing world, the digital marketing world, the coaching, consulting, expert, guru, leader, yada, it feels super saturated at times, and it can feel really, really loud at times. And sometimes we literally feel like we do not know who to listen to anymore because we're hearing so many conflicting messages literally every time you turn around. So my goal is to bring high-level clarity, strategy, system, structure, and ultimately simplicity so that you are not continuing to be freaking frustrated, exhausted, wasting your time, wasting your money, burning out, and not seeing the results that you are highly capable of seeing in your business a lot faster than you're actually seeing it. So welcome again. We're so glad to have you here. And I definitely want you to be engaging with me. So I want to hear your comments in the comment section below. I want to hear what your questions are. So like I said, today is all about how to predict your monthly income in a noisy online market. Wouldn't that be amazing? It is so possible for you to be able to do that. And you're probably thinking like, okay, I'd love to be able to predict my monthly income, but how the heck am I going to get to a place where I literally know like exactly how much money is coming in my bank account every single month? Well, again, it's simple. It is not complex. It's not complicated. It is going to require you to do some work, but it's not super hard to figure out. And I really want to help you get to that place. Type a yes or an emoji or give me some hearts or something in the comments if you love the sound of predictable income every single month. Now, I am not going to tell you some hocus pocus that it is passive income and you've got to set up some fancy Facebook ad funnel and spend $10,000 a month on it. And you could just go to a beach and sip margaritas and martinis and prop your feet up and get a suntan and never, ever look at your freaking funnel and you just make millions of dollars every single month. I don't teach that. If you are interested in that, I am not the coach for you. And that is not the answer that I'm going to give you. Now, does that stuff work? Maybe. I don't know. Find someone who can teach you how to do that. And it actually works without you losing your mind. But I have other answers for you that I think you're actually going to be more interested in. So if you've been in the coaching space or the expert trainer, teacher, mentor space, and if you've been growing your business for a few years, like I have since 2011, 2012, and if you've been around that longer, you know exactly what I'm talking about. It was not that loud back then. It was not that loud. You could literally build a $1 million business as fast as you could snap your fingers when Facebook ads first came out. I watched people do it. And it's still kind of like the Wild West, but it was seriously like the Wild West back then because everything was brand new. And you would see people like jumping on things. Like if you were an early adopter back then, even in like 2012, 13, 14, 15, you know, Periscope, I think, was around in 2015. People who jumped on that and leveraged it, they could build a $1 million business again as fast as they could snap their fingers. When video was new, like what we've really seen is that there really are no barriers to enter the marketplace as a business owner online. You could literally plop up a landing page or start a Facebook group and start driving traffic to that, giving information and selling something on the back end, and you're making money. It can happen that fast. And I know what you might be thinking, I need to sound like that so that people pay attention to me. And so then you start almost like morphing yourself into sounding like everybody else. And I know that some of you might be thinking, like, gosh, these people who are showing up on every single social media platform, literally like selfie in hand, filming every single part of their lives, like, do I have to be loud to be successful online and have predictable income? Do I have to have like this, like crazy in your face kind of almost like an outlier sort of like personality? Do I have to need to have like some kind of shtick about me so that people actually pay attention? Or do I have to be like beautiful and glamorous for this to work? Do I need to like invent something brand new that nobody else has discovered so that people actually listen to me? I know that those are probably a lot of things that are going on in your mind. And if you want to just put in the comments below, what are some of the questions that you're asking yourself? Like, can I do this because I'm not outgoing enough, or I'm introverted, not extroverted, or where's there room for me? Or 15,000 other people have the same message. Like, what's the thing that, you know, the tape that kind of plays in your head about, you maybe just feeling like you don't have, there's not a space for you, or there's not a lane for you? Or do you feel like sometimes when you're showing up online, like you're talking to air? I feel that way sometimes on Instagram, not here. That's why I love having a Facebook group. So let's get right to it. I'm going to teach you, give you five tips of things that you can do, and it will set your business up and you up when you actually effectively deploy these things. You can get to a place where you can literally predict exactly how much money is going to come into your bank account every single month. Number one is have a strategic vision that is you looking further out than just tomorrow or next week, right? So one of the things that I have seen over the years is entrepreneurs waking up every single day and trying to figure out, well, what am I going to do today? What is my message today? What is my content today? What program am I going to offer today? What am I going to write in an email today? How am I going to make money today? Whether it's today or they're coming into a new week and those are all the questions they're asking themselves, or it's a new month and they're asking themselves, how am I going to make money this month? What's my offer going to be this month? What's my content going to be this month? How am I going to move people into my offer this month? What's my message going to be this month? What pictures am I going to use this month? And what's happening, that's one of the reasons why your income is a roller coaster. It's why your sales and your conversions are a roller coaster. It's why clients coming in and you serving clients is like a roller coaster. And there's no real consistency to it because you are playing such a short-term game that you can't even create consistency because it's either changing every day or it's changing every week or it's changing every month. So I highly recommend at least have a strategic vision that is a year out. So 12 months out. Sometimes I hear people say, like, because I really like to work with people on like a 5-year vision. And that's exactly what we did. If you're here and you're one of my risers and Rise to Legendary, shout out to my risers. We just had our summer retreat in June last month in the Cayman Islands. And that was actually one of the things that we did. We started off our training with them mapping out and getting really clear on what's my 5-year vision. What's my 5-year vision? And then we just reverse engineered it. So there's no question about what do I need to actually be focusing on? What are my milestones every single year so that I can actually build out this 5-year vision? If you can't see that far, you know, dial it back. Can you see 3 years out? And if you can't see 3 years out, at least go a year out. So if you wonder, like, what does a 7-figure a year earner do, or someone earning multiple 6 figures? Those folks that you guys follow, they know what their business is going to look like 5 years from now. Some of them even 10 years from now, they've got it all mapped out. So that's tip number one. If you are someone who is waking up every day or every week or every month, and you are just then deciding what you are doing like the next day, week or month, let's kind of switcheroo how we're doing that. And I want you to at minimum create a 5-year vision for yourself, or 1-year vision for yourself, then all you have to do is reverse engineer that. And that's what one of the things that I do with my business clients is help them figure all that stuff out. So strategic vision. Number two is, this is kind of similar, put a strategy and a plan in place. How do you predict your monthly income? People don't predict their monthly income because they have no plan and they have no strategy. And they're flying by the seat of their pants and they're waking up every single day and winging it. If that's how you're operating in your business, then it's going to be really hard for you to ever get to a place where you can predict your income. I teach strategy before tactics. So here's one of the things that you might just be feeling super bogged down by. And if you've been in the industry for a while, you've seen this probably in yourself, possibly even in your own clients and peers, colleagues, friends of yours. And what's happening is so many people out there teaching marketing, they are teaching a certain marketing tactic. So an example might be webinars. A webinar is a tactic. Webinar is not a strategy, right? Speaking from the stage is a tactic. It's not a strategy. Facebook ads is a tactic, not a strategy. So what I've seen happen way too often is someone will say, I'm going to grow my business. I'm going to launch my program and I'm going to do it through webinars. And they start with a tactic, but they forgot to figure out a strategy and a plan. So they go do the webinar. They might even do the webinar a few times and it doesn't work. It's because they were too tactic focused before they were strategy focused. If you go deploy a webinar, even if you do it a few times and you have no strategy, here's what happens. Not enough people sign up. Not enough people come live and you do not hit your sales goals because you do not convert enough people. That is higher level strategy. So you have to start with strategy first. When you have your strategy in place, it doesn't matter what the tactic is, because here's the truth. All the tactics work. I'm not the coach and the online trainer who talks about like, oh, webinars don't work. Like, oh, Facebook ads don't work. None of this stuff works. It all actually works. Everything works. The problem why it doesn't work for so many people is because they are just looking at the tactic. They're looking for instant gratification. They're looking for short-term results. And they think that tactic is the one that's going to spit it back out at them, but they have no strategy. When there's no marketing strategy, there's no conversion strategy, no sales strategy, no delivery strategy, like, oh my gosh. But when you've got the strategy in place, you can take that strategy and you can plug it into any of the tactics and those tactics are going to work much better for you. So strategy over tactic, and then have a plan. Now, some of you might be thinking like, well, what about these people who teach like literally, and I follow some of these people, so I don't knock this at all, but I want you to know the real truth. You'll see people who, and they even teach, wake up every day, tap into what you want to say and go say that. Wake up every day, tap into, meditate on, journal about, whatever, the program I want to offer. When it hits me, go create a sales page and go sell it and put it out there. That works for them. It absolutely works. I don't want to run my business that way, but it totally works. And I learn from some of those folks. But here's the real truth. It's not that those people don't have a system. So to the outside person and the consumer and the audience member who cannot see the behind the scenes of that person's business, they think, oh, I don't need a strategy. I don't need a structure. I don't need a system. I could just show up every day and put my stuff out there. That's not true. And you can't say that because you're not behind the scenes of that business. And I am probably of like the 0.0001% of people who have a coaching and online training business who actually has gotten to work behind the scenes of a $5 million a year coaching business. I did it for 4 years. So I know what goes on behind the scenes of businesses where a huge visionary who does really operate that way actually runs a multi-million dollar business. They still have a quadrillion systems in place. They've just figured out what systems work for them. So don't be confused that those folks don't have systems, because they do. They also have strategies and they also have a plan. And they're deploying a lot of tactics that you don't know anything about because you're only seeing what they're putting out here. So tip number two, have a strategy and a plan if you ever want to predict your monthly income. Number three is build your own niche neighborhood, right? So I have had the fortunate opportunity over the last 8 years to work with thousands, plural, thousands of women entrepreneurs growing businesses online. I have had a front row seat into what works and what doesn't work. I've had a front row seat into watching people literally go from what it seems like zero to six and multiple six figures, even seven figures in 12, 18 months, 24 months time. And I've seen a lot of those people just keep spinning their wheels year after year after year. And when I work with clients now and they get really frustrated with like, why is my stuff not selling more? Why am I not selling more of my offers? Why are people not buying all this stuff? And so when I kind of zoom out from a strategic bird's eye view level, one of the difference makers that I've noticed between entrepreneurs online who are soaring more quickly and they are selling more of their programs and they're doing it with greater ease and they're doing it faster versus the ones who it just seems like it's not quite, the wheels aren't really getting off the ground. One of the biggest difference makers I've seen is that the people who are growing faster and with more ease, they built a strong community. They've got a community. An example of that is you guys right here. This is my community. This is what I call my niche neighborhood. This group was started specifically for service-based entrepreneurs, coaches, online trainers, and experts and consultants. That's my niche. And this is our neighborhood. This is where we come together. This is where I'm building a community of people who want to link arms together. This is where I get to engage with you. It's where I get to ask you questions. It's where we get to know each other better. It's where I get to do really cool stuff like this and come and teach you amazing content so that you're getting epiphanies and ahas and having a breakthrough and getting some momentum. And then it's my group, so I can make offers here for those of you who want to take it to the next level. You can work with me. And so this is a place where I can essentially sell to you inside here. So when I've seen entrepreneurs like not really be able to get the wheels off the ground, typically those are people who have not built a community. A niche community is also a niche neighborhood. It's a long-term strategy. So you're going to kind of constantly have short and long-term strategies. Building a community, you're not doing it just so you can make fast money tomorrow. This is a long-term strategy that's going to help you be more consistent in your business, have predictable income, and also be able to sustain high levels of growth over the long term. So tip number three is you need to have your own niche neighborhood. Tip number five, if you want to be able to predict your monthly income in the online space, in this very noisy space, you are going to have group programs, courses, basically leveraged programs where you are teaching and leading, mentoring, guiding, coaching, whatever word you like to use in a one-to-many style. So one-to-many is like, I used to be a high school teacher. So that's a teacher of a classroom of 30 students is an example of one-to-many. I would have 30 students come in my class. There was one teacher at the front of the room. It was me. I was teaching one-to-many. So that's like a group coaching program. That's a mastermind program. That's an online course. That can also be self-study courses. But it becomes increasingly difficult to predict your monthly income if the only offer you have is one-on-one. And that's what I've seen. I rebooted my business in 2017 and I rebooted it by coaching one-on-one. And I got to a point really fast. I mean, within 45 days, I had 10 one-on-one clients in 2017 after rebooting. And then by May, I had over 20 one-on-one clients. And I was delivering and coaching, trading dollars for hours, 30 hours a week. 30 hours a week, Monday through Friday. So that did not leave me time, hardly at all, to have planning and strategic time to work on my business. So strategy and planning and working with team and hiring team and training and thinking higher level, vision casting, strategic thinking, that's all you working on your business. working in your business is very much what my week this week has looked like and what my 2017 looks like, which is just trading, just coaching clients, just giving what you have sold and you're delivering it. If you're doing that 30 hours a week, you don't have time to grow a business. You just don't. And what I've seen happen to almost everybody, when they are overwhelmed with the one-on-one, their foot comes off the gas pedal of marketing. And they stop marketing for like 3 or 4 months, which means they haven't been frequently cultivating a community. They haven't been consistently and frequently engaging with people and building relationships. They haven't been making offers consistently. And that community kind of fizzles out a little bit. And so 3, 4 months later, that person is like, holy cow, everybody's contracts are ending. Where am I going to find the next client? And their community has kind of deflated. And now they have to rev the engine all the way up again. And that really creates this roller coaster thing. And you feel like you're constantly chasing one-on-one clients. Now, if you like coaching one-on-one, awesome. If you want that to be part of your business plan, amazing. I'm not knocking one-on-one coaching. I'm just saying, if you want long-term predictable income on a monthly basis, you are going to have leveraged programs. And you have to get really good at the marketing and the sales of those programs. You also have to get really good at knowing how to structure and deliver those programs so that you've got happy clients and happy customers who keep coming back, who tell their friends about you, and who actually get results. Because one of the best ways to grow your business is teaching programs and coaching your clients to actually get results. They're your best marketing. It's called invisible marketing. So if you want to be able to predict your income, you got to start rolling groups out and leading groups, courses, self-study, something like that. My fifth and final tip on how to predict your monthly income in your online business as a service-based entrepreneur is you must host content-rich conversion events consistently. That's a lot of C's, wasn't it? Content-rich conversion events consistently. So let me give you an example of how this is going to shift things in your business. What I have seen most people do is they will have a new program and they will launch their new program and they will have a goal for 25 people to join their program and they make 4 sales. That's great though. That's like the first time they launch that program. The goal is 30, they get 4 sales. And so they get really upset. They get really frustrated. They stomp off. They beat themselves up. They judge themselves. They say, nobody likes me. This shit doesn't work. I need to offer something else. And I need to offer it in a completely different way. I need to market it and sell it in a completely different way. So they go head off for 4 months, 5 months, 6 months. They come back. They have a new offer, slightly different. They roll it out and launch it in a completely new way using new tactics all over again. They have a goal of 30 people and this time 6 people join. And then they play the whole thing all over again. They go crawl in a hole for 6 months. They come back. Now it's been a year and they've only tried to launch 2 times in a year. So conversion events need to be happening a lot more often. So there's so much squeamishness around sales and asking and offering and putting that out in front of your audience because there's such a fear. And I want to know what your fears are about selling. If you're here, you're in business and you are selling something. What is your concern or your fear or your holdup about making offers more often to your community? Because the only way to keep your doors open is if you're making money, new money, and sales are coming in. You have to make offers consistently for that to come in. I want to know, like, what's holding you back? What's the squeamishness around, like, constantly, consistently offering to your community and your people, your list, your audience? Tell me what that is in the comments because I want to see that because I can do some more trainings on that as well. So what happens is you are in the online space. You have to get good at launching. You have to learn how to launch your programs. You've got to master launching. It's one of the things that we teach inside of our paid programs, how to actually do that without the frustration, without the complexity, without the bells and whistles, without having to spend $50,000 upfront to actually launch. I have a certain way that I teach that inside of our paid programs. That has to be done consistently. The only way you are going to master that, you don't master that because you go take a class or a course and then you go do it one time and it doesn't work and you stomp off for 6 months. You have to get back up and you've got to launch a second time, the same program. The third time, the same program. A fourth time, the same program. A fifth time, the same program. A sixth time, the same program. Maybe by the fifth or sixth time that you launch it, and I'm saying like you got to launch that like 5, 6, 7 times in a year, like in a 12-month period of time, you've got to launch that program over and over and over again, because you've got to figure out how to convert people. You've got to figure out how to take people who are just out here, strangers to you. You've got to move them all the way through your whole entire marketing strategy, conversion sales process to the point where they actually buy from you. And do you know how many touches somebody needs before they actually take action? 16. Somebody, a prospect out there, you have to touch them 16 times or more before they actually take an action. So the way that you are going to master filling your programs and the way you're going to create consistent income in your business that is predictable is because you're going to dust yourself off faster than everybody else is out there. You're not going to go crawl in your hole and cover your face up and get underneath the covers. And you're going to look at what worked, what didn't work. Where do I need to improve? Who do I need to hire to help me improve? What do I need to say differently? What do I need to do differently to have more volumes of people register for my conversion event? What do I need to do differently to position my offer as the one and only offer that people have got to have so that they can achieve the result that they want, that I say I can deliver on? You can't go crawl in a hole and get under the covers every 6 months and then come back out of hibernating and think that people are going to buy from you. The first time you launch, you might get 2 people who buy from you. The second time you launch, maybe it goes up to 10. The third time you launch, now you're cooking and maybe 20 people. The fourth time you launch, maybe it's 50. The fifth and sixth time you launch, now you're going to have your 6-figure launch. The same program, launching it the same way and just tweaking what needs to be tweaked. Do you see if you launch every so often in a year's time, do you just see how quickly you could be at multiple 6 figures in 12 months if you just show up consistently and you practice repetition and discipline? There's your predictable income right there. Why are more people not doing this? Because it's work. Because it's work, and most people don't want to work. And most people are looking for the short-term instant gratification and they don't want to wait. But you're different because you're here for the long term. So let me recap 5 ways that you can predict your monthly income in the online space. I hope you notice there is no magic wand. There is no magic pill. There is no magic formula. It's kind of consistency, repetition, frequency. It's getting back to the basic principles. And it's repeating it over and over and over again to get better and better and better and master it. So few people are willing to do that. It's so crowded at the bottom, you guys. It's so crowded down here. Nobody's doing it. You be the one who does it so that you're up here in a very uncrowded, unnoisy place so that you are the leader of your field. So when we think of your area of expertise, we think of you and your name, and we bring all of our friends along with us because you're the one who is showing up consistently. And if somebody wants to type this in the comments for me, I would so appreciate that so everybody can see it. Number one is have a strategic vision, either 1, 3, or 5 years out, whichever one you can handle, but definitely a year out. Number two, have a strategy and a plan in place, strategy before tactic. Number three is build your own niche neighborhood and build relationships with those people. Number four, offer leveraged programs. Offer leveraged programs that are one to many, like group programs, online courses, self-study, those kinds of things. I'm not saying you have to do all of that. I just wanted to give you some examples. And number five is host content-rich conversion events consistently. Oh, and I didn't tell you what a conversion event was. I'll give you an example. A conversion event could pretty much be anything. It could be a video series. It could be a 5-day challenge. It could be a 3-day workshop. It could be a 4-part free online course. Basically, it's an event that you drive traffic to. You give people a lot of value. And then at the end, you make an offer to your paid program. And there's like a whole entire system, structure, strategy to how all that works, which we teach inside of our programs. Thank you guys. I hope you got a tremendous amount of value out of today's live show on Thursday. If you are here live or you're listening to the replay, tell me what your biggest takeaway was. Did you have an aha? Did you have some sort of like breakthrough moment when you were hearing this today? Did you have like one big takeaway that you can, and when I ask for these things, like I want you to have a takeaway. I want you to have a breakthrough. I want you to have like a little piece of clarity when I come in and do these trainings. And I don't want you to just sit on that and forget about it. I want you to actually go take a peek at your business and go do something with the breakthrough or the takeaway that you just had. Thanks for being here, everybody. I will see you inside the Facebook group, I'm sure, the next few days. And then I'll see you back here live at 5 p.m. Eastern time next Thursday. Until then, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.